Hello and welcome to another episode of It's Not Hard, where we look at the uses, construction, and tying techniques of knots. Remember, there's no right way to tie a knot, but there are plenty of wrong ways, so always check your knot before trusting it to any critical load. Today we're going to look at a trucker's hitch. A trucker's hitch is useful for securing loads, or for a line that needs to be tensioned, like a tarp ridge line, or a tent stake line. And there's many variations on this setup, but they all have three things in common. They all have an eye loop up top, up here. That's where you hook through and create your leverage. They all have an anchor point at the bottom. This could be a tent stake, or maybe it's a D-ring on your piece of equipment that you're hooking to. And then they all have a hitch at the end, some way to tie off and finish the knot. How you do each of these might be different depending on the version. And in Ashley's Book of Knots, the real trucker's hitch is more complicated than what I'm showing here. This is a simplified version that's useful for camping or really light loads. I wouldn't trust this to any kind of critical load or heavy load, but it's more than adequate for camping and outdoor needs. Okay, so let's look at each of the three parts of this setup. If this is my working end over here, at some point I'm going to create a eye loop. And I do that by simply taking a twist, making a loop, so my working end is under my standing end. And then I take the working end and feed it back through. So I take a bite, feed it through, and pull it like that. Now I've created an eye loop up here. Now this is not stable. So this is one of the reasons why this is both easier but also not as reliable, because if I pull this, it pulls right back through again. Great for taking down your tarp or your tent, but not great for secure loads. So don't trust this loop for secure loads. Ashley has a different style for making it more secure. So you create your eye loop. I'll do that again. I'll do it a little further up here so I have more room. I take my rope, I twist it this way, and I feed the working end back through with just a little bite. And that bite becomes the eye loop. Like that. So once you've got your eye loop, and you're not pulling on it, so you're not pulling it out, then you take your working end, hook it through your anchor point, wherever that is, and bring it back up. And now let's finish off by passing the working end through the eye I created, the eye loop, tensioning it. So now I can tension it to whatever level of tension I want, and I've got that 3-1 mechanical advantage. Once you get it where you want it, you can just grab that right there. That would hold it in place. Then I like to pass it down around like that. And all you're doing is making a bite and passing it back through the loop right there. And then I'm pulling it tight. No, I didn't leave enough slack on that one. But that's the basic idea, because then I have a tail here on this slippery hitch where I can just pull it out to release it or retension it, So if I need to retension that nut, retension that line, I can retension it and just secure it again really quickly by just going around. There, make my bite, and pass it through, and tighten it up. And that's secure. And that's my trucker's hitch. Thanks for watching, and remember, with a little patience and a little practice, it's not hard.